All right, so class is about to start, so I'm going to record this video as quickly as I can, and then I might need to record another one later today. This is a really challenging problem. So it says to use the definition of the derivative to evaluate the limit. There's a couple of ways you can do this. The main thing you have to be able to do is visualize this as an exponential function. Remember that the definition of the derivative goes back to, I'll write it out here, the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. So we have to be able to recognize that this is the definition of the derivative. Limit as h goes to 0, you got h on the bottom. So that means that this is f of x and this is f of x plus h. Now if that's the case, since I have the plus h in the base and the exponent, that means my original f of x problem or equation would have had x in the base and the exponent. So there's two ways to think about this problem. You can think about it as the function f of x equals x to the power of x minus 2. And we're looking when x is 6, because you've got 6 plus h. And if I did 6 plus h minus 2, that would give me 4 plus h. And then you can use the technique of logs, because the definition of the derivative is basically just saying find the derivative and plug in that x value. I don't have the work shown here, but if you do the derivative of this, you'd use the technique of logs, and you'd end up getting f prime equals this. So I can just plug 6 into the equation. My answer would have looked like this. It's equivalent to the MathXL's answer, but I would have typed it in this way. Another way you can do this problem is by doing L-hop. The top and the bottom are both going to evaluate to be 0, the limits, like as h approaches 0, both the limit on the top and the bottom evaluate to be 0, so we can use L-hop. I didn't write out all the limit statements because I didn't have room. But when I take the derivative of h, it's going to go to 1, so I'm going to be dividing by 1. When I take the derivative of this constant, it goes away, so I don't have to worry about it. When I take the derivative of this function, 6 plus h to the power of 4 plus h, I'm going to use the technique of logs. And this is the same value, like ln on both sides. This process would be the same if I was going to take the derivative here. So you can follow the same steps here. So take natural log on both sides, move the 4 plus h in front, use the product rule, multiply the y over, and then you can simplify. Now this whole thing was a limit as h approaches 0. And again, I'm not showing all the correct notation because I'm trying to do this quickly. But if I plug in h as 0 here, then you're going to end up getting the version of the answer that I put in. So you can either use L-hop and then take the derivative of this and you use the technique of logs, or you recognize that this is the function x to the power of x minus 2 and we're looking at when x is 6, and then use the technique of logs to get the derivative that way. Again, this is a very challenging problem. So take a look at this video and this explanation and the work I did. Take another attempt. If you need more help, either come by tutorials or let me know and I can try to record another video. All right, good luck.